welcome to my channel Fern's Life. In this video, I'm going to be showing you my curly hair routine. What do I do before and after the hair wash and how do I manage and maintain the curls? So if you're interested, do join me and watch the rest.
I'm planning to wash my hair tomorrow. So today I'll be oiling it, leaving it. I use to oil my hair. Most important thing, coconut oil. I use this one, which is from CocoSol. It is 100% natural cold pressed virgin coconut oil. I use it for my daughter as well, and my husband also uses. So this is the coconut oil that we use. Along with that coconut oil, I also add a little bit of almond oil. This one is what I'm using. It's from the brand TNW, the natural wash. And it comes in this box. It is this bottle. Both of these are available on Amazon. So I put coconut oil and then I also add a little almond oil in a bowl. Oiling of hair is very important before you shampoo. See that curly hair requires a lot of moisture. So when I rub the oil in the scalp and leave it for a day and night, it gives my hair the moisture that I need. And then when I wash it, it's not damaging my hair a lot, because while shampoos tend to dry out your hair a lot, it is still retaining the moisture. When I want to use the hair mask for my hair, what I usually do is I add a little aloe vera gel. This one is from the brand Wow Skin Science. Little aloe vera gel and the required quantity of hair mask. And I apply it, you know, in the roots and on the lengths. So this is what I usually do before shampooing and conditioning. And now the moment of truth, where you will see the frizziness in my hair. So this is how my hair is right now. It's not at all in its shape, in its curls. In fact, because of tying my hair continuously, it has become flat here. And I've got grays as well, which I need to cover very soon. But yeah, this is how. Avoid combing your hair even after oiling it. I do not. It just damages the whole, the curls that you have. So avoid combing your hair or using your comb. Okay, so the oiling is done. There we go. There's some oil left. And now I should use it for Sophie. I'll oil her hair as well. And that's it. I'm going to be like this the whole day, whole night. And then when I wash my hair tomorrow, I'm going to show you how it looks. So stay tuned and watch the rest of the video. So I'll quickly just, scrunch it up a little bit. And in the process, I'll be pulling out the excess water. We don't want to make it too dry. Also, I'm using a microfiber cloth. You can use a microfiber towel, but this is sufficient for me. So once that's done, let me quickly share with you how did I shampoo and condition my hair. So I use, which is the curl moisturizing shampoo, and the conditioner is the curl hydrating conditioner. So these are the products that I've used to wash my hair. So when you shampoo it, I prefer doing it from the roots to the lengths. After we've shampooed our hair, I then apply conditioner. How I apply conditioner, I'll let you know. I take the amount that I need and I rub it on this side. Same way I'll rub it on this side. Once I've got the condition, remember I told you that I only comb my hair during conditioning and sometimes while styling. This is the comb that I use. It is from the brand Exo Curls. Got these wide gaps. That's what's recommended for curly hair. And when I comb my hair, I comb it from down. And then from down, I move towards the top. And that way, I try to detangle the hair and remove all the knots. Now, my honest observation is that I have only one or two strands that I see on the comb after the combing is done, and I'm not exaggerating. I'll be very honest. Initially, when I started using these products on my hair, I was seeing hair fall, considerable amount of hair fall, not much of a concern, but there was hair fall, and I felt that maybe these products don't suit my hair, but this is the first ever product that I tried when I started my CG journey, and I thought maybe it will take time to adjust, and because obviously these products require time to finish it completely, I thought I have to anyways use it. So while using it, I realized that it is now the hair fall has gone much less, it's reduced. And why I don't comb my hair when it's dry, that's because when it's dry, it's frizzy, it's unruly, and then there is a chance of more hair fall because you're literally trying to open up all the knots and the hair is not manageable. But after conditioning, when I comb my hair into, after you know, making two sections, it helps with the detangling and it helps with hair fall. So both of these things are under control. So that's how I did, and that's how the whole shampoo conditioning process works for me. Now what we'll do is we will do the hair styling. So I'm going to show you how I do the hair styling. I'm currently using the Arata hair styling product, which is Arata hair cream and Arata hair styling gel. It's lasted for 5 months. So that's how much these products have lasted. I'll now style my hair and show you how I do it. The hair cream is almost over. If you see closely, like there's hardly anything left, which is why when I ordered these recently, I ordered the bundle pack, and in the bundle pack I also got the curl defining cream. I have not used it. It is still hear that sound? I don't know if it's getting captured on camera, but that's the sound where it shows the product has mixed well with your hair along with the water that was on your hair. So having a wet hair, that is dripping, soaking wet hair, is very important when you use these kind of hairstyling products. That's it. Scrunching is done. So the cream work is done. Now we'll move on to using the gel. Now, if you want, at this point also you can use the comb, which I generally do. All that I do. Now, very important, do not touch your hair when it is drying. Whenever a curly hair needs to be tied, I always use these silk scrunchies. Scrunchies are recommended. I've used it and I love my experience using scrunchies to make sure that my curls are maintained while sleeping. This hair bonnet, it's a satin silk hair bonnet. Bonnet, I think, is what it's called. But this is what I use. I tie my hair in it. I also have a satin silk pillowcase. So that too helps in making sure that your curls remain as it is. And that has really made a big difference, because a lot of times when I sleep and I get up, I don't have control over my curls during my sleep. But then the next day, the curls are damaged. So having these two things while I'm sleeping is a very big sleeping essential to make sure my curls are in place. So here's my hair all dried. This is how it looks after applying those styling cream and hair gel. The hair is a little on the hard side because there's a cast that gets formed after applying the gel. So all that you need to do is basically take your fingers and to the roots, just brush it up. What happens is it opens up the hair, gives it volume and removes the cast. It's not like much of a problem even if there is a cast. It just keeps your hair curled and, you know, maintained the whole day. And that's it. If you like, at this point, you can also use a hair oil. Not any hair oil. There are these CG recommended hair oils. One which comes from the range of Curlup products. There's also Righteous Roots. I don't have any of them. I'm planning on using the Curlup one. So we take a little, it acts like a serum basically, where you can just scrunch, it's called SOTC, scrunch out the crunch. Yes, this is a crunch that the cast makes, and scrunching out the crunch meaning you take a little oil and you just scrunch it out. And you basically don't have that hardness in the hair. But yeah, this is how it is, and this is how it's going to be pretty much for the rest of the day. I will show you how my curls look like after I've got up from sleep tomorrow. So do watch that as well. That way you will know how the curls have maintained the whole day as well as in the night. Wash. So an entire day has passed, and today would be my second day of post washing my hair. So I'll quickly show you how it looks. So if you see, the curls are still there, and if I like, I can pretty much keep it this way. But if you want to sort of refresh your curls, small spray bottle. What's good about this bottle is that I notice the right quantity of water, and this is what I'm talking about. Like if I spray, so see, if you see the spray, it gets sprayed properly. So I feel this one works well for me rather than investing in all those expensive bottles. I thought if this one does what it needs to, then it doesn't make sense going for those bottles. So that's how I quickly wet my hair. And then I use the Arata hair gel, a very little quantity. That's it. I've used only so much. Just needed a little water and a hairstyling gel, the same one that I used when I washed my hair. See you tomorrow with my day 3 curls. Hi there, and welcome to day 3 post my hair wash. Let me show you how the hair still looks post the styling treatment that I did. The curls still look as maintained. What I will do is I'll only kind of style the areas which look a little frizzier than the others. For example, the front, if you see the curls. The phone fell while I was shooting. Anyway, sorry for the interruption. So yes, I was saying that I will be styling my hair using the same hair gel which I had used on the first day of hair wash. Post wash, I use this gel for hair styling, and again I'll take very little quantity. And this is how the hair looks on day 3. This is the last clip that I'll be showing you how my hair looks like post hair wash and what I do to refresh it, because tomorrow being day 4 day 5, I usually plan on washing my hair at around that time. So it wouldn't make sense because I'll be again washing. It doesn't really need to be washed, but it depends on how frizzier it gets. This is what it is on day 3. Why do I keep saying day 2? Day 3. It looks pretty good to me. Quite defined. Don't need to do much mehnat, you know, daily. People think that maintaining curly hair, I was one of them. I thought the same. Maintaining curly hair is a task, but I thought that because I didn't have knowledge about it. And now that I have the required knowledge and I'm able to do it so easily, I am very happy, and I wanted to obviously share that with all of you. So I hope you liked this video and you found it helpful, useful. If you're a person like me who's got this kind of hair, then I would suggest to try out the methods that I've tried, or else research yourself and figure out what works best for you for your hair. But I highly recommend to, you know, give this routine a try, because that's how your natural hair is. Until the time you do not nurture it and work according to your hair type, you'll never know the real beauty that you have within you, right? I never knew this. I never ever explored this part of how my hair would look when it's curled so well. So I'm very happy, and I thought I will share this with all of you so that it makes you happy. While I'm sharing with you what I do to maintain my curls, I thought I'll also let you know the reason why I thought of making this video. So there were times when I hated my hair. I didn't like my hair simply because I didn't know how to manage it. Here I used to straighten my hair, and it just became a habit, and I felt straightened hair is much more manageable as compared to curly hair, because the curly hair, the amount of frizz it carries with it, the more I comb the curly hair, the more frizzier it gets. Then I have to tie it every time, and then even after tying it, you know, the head starts to pain, and that's just that one hairstyle that I carry every time, which is tying up, because I don't know what to do when it's open. So these were the reasons why I stuck to straightening my hair, and I used to straighten my hair every year. I then started to notice a few girls around, you know, maybe my workplace or wherever I've spotted any girl having good curls. So I tried to understand from them, how did you manage? But I didn't get any straight and clear answer when it comes to the right products to be used or the steps to be done. They were just random things that they tried, and it didn't really help me much, and I was struggling to know how do I keep up with my natural hair. And it's only recently, I think during the lockdown only, which was lockdown 2020, where I started to research more and understand how curly hair is maintained, what is CG, what is this curly girl, CG basically means curly girl routine, CG routine, so you CG friendly products, CG routine, these are the terms used for curly hair maintenance. And I started to research more, understand what this means, how it is done, and I came across a few details on Pinterest, on Instagram accounts that spoke specifically about how to manage curly hair. And I learned all that information really helped me to then figure out what I want to do with my hair. And I think I started, making a promise to myself that let's do this. Let's start the CG routine that, you know, everyone is talking about and how well they manage it. So I started. My first investment, I think I remember, was buying the satin silk pillow cover and scrunchie. It was a bundle pack. So switched to paraben free, silicone free products. So I started with Mama Earth shampoo conditioner. I even used their hair mask. I think I did that because my hair was in the transitioning phase. So I had straightened my hair, and from straightened hair, I was now starting to get my natural curls. So I didn't want to switch to CG friendly products directly, because I had half straight, half curly. And I thought I'll use products that will be soft and gentle on the hair texture. And then I came across these products, which people spoke about were recommended as it's paraben free and silicon free. Using the Curl Up range product, it talks here about it. Sulfate, paraben and silicon free. That's how important that is. So I switched to Mama Earth products. I had a good experience, but they didn't give me the curls that I wanted. Then I invested in scrunchies. I invested in these kind of scrunchies, and I started to notice that the frizz is managed, and with the way the overall hair texture is, you know, when you open your hair and tie it up, it is not very tough. So that was another good experience I came across. And then slowly I said, okay, now it's time where all my straight hair vanished and I had only curls left. So let's now get into buying curly hair products. That's when I invested in the Curl Up range shampoo, conditioner and the Arata range of hair styling products. And since then, I haven't switched to anything. I never imagined that I'll be talking about how curly hair is managed. But I did this because I know how much I struggled to learn this. And I didn't get answers from people. And I researched and I tried to figure out myself. And that research has really helped me keep up with the natural hair that I have. And I'm in love with the way my hair is now. But here I am, I'm doing it. And I want to do it because I know how much of help this information is, how much of help this knowledge is. It helped me. And I really want to use this platform to help you. So if you are a person like me struggling with curly hair, you know, it's not compulsory that you follow each and everything I said. This is my experience. This is what's worked for me. You are free to research depending on your hair type as well. If you're not aware, I'll also add there are different kind of hair types. Mine is a 3A, 3B type. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 being completely straight to 4 being very coiled and heavily curled. So minus 3, I'm not that kind of coiled or heavily curled hair type. And 2 being wavy. So yeah, so you decide what hair type you have. You experiment with products. You will then know which product suits your hair. And this is my experience. This is what I feel. So I thought I'll share it with all of you. Hopefully it helps. If you have any questions, anything that you want to know, let me know in the comments so that I can answer it for you if I can. I will definitely try. But I'm doing this with the intention for all of you to realize and recognize yourself, your natural self, natural hair, and there is a way to manage it. There is definitely a way. I figured that out, and I would really like if you too. So this has been why I really wanted to make a mention of my honest journey with maintaining curly hair, and this is what it is. So yeah, bringing to you more content which will suit your requirements, suit your purpose of watching YouTube, or maybe just fun stuff. But I hope you like whatever you see, and if you do, please like, please comment, let me know how I can be better, and also subscribe to my channel. So thank you so much for joining me, and we'll see you in my next video.